As viewers of this programme will know, Labour Party bosses allied to Keir Starmer have been working on overdrive to suspend party members who dare to debate whether or not Keir Starmer was right to remove the whip from Jeremy Corbyn. On Thursday, the latest victim of this purge was a prominent Jewish activist, Naomi Wimborne Adrissi. Wimborne Adrissi is vice chair of the local party in Chingford and Woodford Green and was suspended after allowing a motion in solidarity with Jeremy Corbyn to be heard. I invited Naomi onto the show, but apparently, if you've been suspended from the Labour Party, you also get a bit of a gagging order, so you're not supposed to discuss the case, which seems a little bit one-sided, considering that you've got people within the party briefing the press, and in many cases, you get frontbench MPs sort of speaking up and talking about these things. But in any case, as an introduction to who Naomi Wimborne Adrissi is, and we're going to show you a clip from a recent interview she did with our friends at Double Down News. It's been viewed about a million times now on Twitter. So it's really kicking off that the Labour Party have suspended Naomi. Let's take a look.
Not a proper Jew. The wrong sort of Jew. Self-hating Jew. I was called that for the first time when I was 19 years old at university, where I made a speech in defence of a pro-Palestinian motion. And it was in the Jewish Telegraph. And they front-paged it, this self-hating Jew. She must hate herself when she looks in the mirror. I was 19 years old. I've had people phone me up and say, we're going to put you in a wheelchair. We know where you are. We're outside your door. Probably the worst incident was when I was with my sister at a meeting about anti-Semitism with all Jews on the panel. And people were shouting at us, capos, capos.
You're called traitor Jews, capos.
Capo was a Jewish inmate of a concentration camp who collaborated with the authorities. We're talking people who collaborated in annihilation of their own people. So it's a pretty bad thing to be called. And it's Jews calling other Jews. Not nice. As a Jew on the left, and who is intensely anti-racist and intensely aware of what anti-Semitism is and how dangerous it is, to be called an anti-Semite oneself is about as low as it gets. It's a bit like being accused of paedophilia or something. I cannot really think of anything worse. And it undermines the fight against real anti-Semitism. This is one of the most frightening things for me. People have been weaponizing accusations of anti-Semitism for political ends. The fact that that is going on seriously undermines and endangers our chances of dealing with genuine anti-Semitism, which is a real threat in our society. One of the most ludicrous allegations against Jeremy Corbyn was that he exhibited anti-Semitism in chairing a meeting in 2010 in Portcullis House, where the main speaker was a Holocaust survivor from the Netherlands called Hayo Mayer. I was at that meeting, and what Hayo did was to put on a screen comparisons between the treatment of Palestinians in the occupied territories and the treatment of Jews in areas occupied by the Nazis. And there were uncanny and very unnerving similarities between the way these two communities were treated by the occupying powers in each case.
I saw in Auschwitz that if a dominant group wants to dehumanize others, so as the Nazis wanted to dehumanize me, this dominant group must first be dehumanized in a way themselves by diminishing their empathy due to propaganda and indoctrination in order to be able to be as cruel as some were. Okay? But the same holds nowadays for Israel.
The most shocking thing to me is the portrayal of that meeting as somehow despicable because we saw a Holocaust survivor comparing his experiences with what he could see happening to Palestinians. What was horrifying about that meeting was that there were a bunch of really intolerant, bigoted, aggressive, bullying, pro-Israel campaigners in that room who shouted Hayo down. It went on for a long time, and lots of us in the audience was sort of saying to Jeremy, can you please call the authorities to get these people out? They are harassing and intimidating an 80 plus year old Holocaust survivor. It was intimidating. It really was to be there. I remember it vividly.
That was a section of a video that's about 10 minutes long. I do recommend going to watch the whole thing. Double Down News obviously good friends of ours, make loads of brilliant content. So Faiza Shaheen was the candidate to be MP in Chingford and Woodford Greens. So that's the constituency where Naomi is vice chair. So Faiza tweeted, Naomi lives local to me and was kind enough to offer her car to us during the election. During lockdown one, when I was organising deliveries for those shielding, I gave her one of our most needy callers because I knew she'd be kind and patient. She doesn't deserve this. Also, Mehdi Hassan, obviously a very prominent British journalist now working in the United States. So he quote tweeted the Double Down News tweet, which bore the news of her suspension and wrote, whatever your views on Labour or Corbyn, you should listen to this eloquent woman speak and hear what she's had to put up with. Finally, we've got a tweet from John McDonnell, who's probably now, you know, the most senior Labour left backbencher, who tweets, I know Naomi Wimborne Adrisi. She's a decent, sincere socialist. Not everybody may agree with everything Naomi says. We all have the right to speak and the right to disagree, but disagreement shouldn't result in suspension. I'd be a witness for her at any party disciplinary hearing. That seems quite significant, especially that final one, because that's a sitting MP and a sitting MP who has sort of, you know, attempted to have a strategy which is quite conciliatory towards Keir Starmer. So it seems significant that he has spoken out about a suspension of an individual member, which is something which, you know, is very much frowned upon by the leadership. So I think he's putting his neck out a little bit there, which, I mean, hopefully means some progress will be made, but it's very difficult to say. I'm going to go to Aaron in one moment. First of all, if you're enjoying the show, if you're enjoying Navarra Media in general, please do and remember to subscribe to the channel. Hit that subscribe button, hit that notifications button, because we will be talking every week about all the big stories that are going on in this country. Aaron, I want your thoughts on this. Do you think that now the party in their, I mean, we can call this a purge now, basically, can't we? In their huge drive to suspend, as Angela Rayner said, thousands and thousands of members, now they're, you know, suspending quite prominent Jewish activists for being implicated supposedly in anti-Semitism. I mean, I presume that's what we're supposed to infer from the suspension. Do you think this is going to be something which creates more pushback than we've seen up to now?
Yeah, I think it will get worse. I don't think they'll make the right decisions. I think they'll carry on. I think they'll dig their heels in. I think they'll keep on digging the hole. And I think their polling will continue to deteriorate. There's a poll out this evening which has Labour down 2. The lead between Boris Johnson and Keir Starmer in terms of who would you like to see as Prime Minister is at its highest since August. Now, partly that's because, of course, of the fantastic news on a vaccine. Most people think, right, we're out of the worst of this. We'll have a modicum of reality come back in, say, March. We've got furlough until then. I'm really happy the government's behaved in the way that it has. I think that's clearly one variable. But another one is they're looking at what's going on in Labour. You've got, I think, more than 60 CLPs now saying they want Corbyn to have the whip restored. The party in no way feels or looks like it's talking out to society at large. That's because it's not, by the way. Keir Starmer has absolutely no policies, which partly explains this determination to fight a permanent war with much of the Labour Party membership, because he has to do something, right? And I think their polling will continue to deteriorate. I think it will. And I think they're going to be in real trouble if they carry on with this for another month or two. But what else can they do now? They've got no alternative. And I said this on the day that Jeremy Corbyn was suspended, I emailed Paul Mason, actually. I'll say this. I won't say what he said, because it's a private communication. But I said, this is the day that Keir Starmer absolutely secured the next general election for the Tory party. This is the single best day for the Conservative Party and the British establishment in a very long time. In a very long time. You've just had Marcus Rashford highlight children going without school meals, getting the government to U-turn. You're making real progress on progressive politics in the context of COVID, which actually Labour have really struggled with. And this is what you do. I mean, the man's an idiot, and the people instructing him are idiots. And there's absolutely no evidence that they're going to change course from this, I'm afraid. You know, like you say, just a few days ago, Angela Rayner saying, I will suspend thousands of people. First of all, by the way, that comment recuses her from any process because she's clearly not independent, right? I mean, we're just dealing with unserious people, and this is a deeply serious matter. And I think people probably quite rightly look at them and say, you're not really capable of governing the country. Certainly not better than the Tories. That's a really sad thing to say. Now, clearly many people said that with Jeremy Corbyn too. At least with Jeremy Corbyn, you have a structural explanation. The left doesn't have lots of bureaucrats, civil servants. It's not been tested in a position of power for decades. That was all the case, by the way. But with Keir Starmer, you've got the centrist media batting for him. He's getting a light, you know, he's basically being let off the hook most of the time by the BBC. He's getting nothing like what Jeremy Corbyn had. His policy agenda isn't particularly radical, and yet he's decided to kind of self-detonate his own prospects for entering 10 Downing Street. It's inexplicable, really, and I think, frankly, it has to be attributed to the fact he's advised by people whose primary concern is not winning the next general election, but destroying the left. And I think, ultimately, that's going to destroy Keir Starmer.
And it is difficult to see where this goes. I mean, I've asked people who I thought might know what the plan is, and I still can't really work out what the leadership are expecting to do with all of these suspensions of chairs and vice chairs, because I think upwards of 70 constituencies have now passed motions in solidarity with Jeremy Corbyn. There will be more of those, more than those which wanted to but decided not to because they didn't want to break the rules and didn't want to get themselves suspended. We spoke to Corey Drew on this program, who had to make that very difficult decision herself. So there's clearly an enormous amount of anger at the grassroots of the party, which isn't going to go anywhere. And I mean, it does seem like the Labour Party or the Labour Party bosses are either going to have to step back or they will be suspending thousands of people, just as Angela Rayner said, which, I mean, seems like a pretty risky strategy to take if you're seriously interested in winning power. And it will, I mean, you can already see sort of the amount of pushback there has been about this suspension, that people do think this just looks ridiculous. It's not really credible to be suspending this many people, especially Jewish people, for, you know, supposed approximation to anti-Semitism because they voted to reinstate the whip to someone who hasn't even been suspended from the party, someone who's been readmitted to the Labour Party. They're now voting they should get the whip back, and now you're having a mass expulsions all over the country. Completely incoherent, completely authoritarian, and it has to end.